Honorable Sir, I was working as a nurse some time ago, and I was working in intensive care unit. What I would like to ask is, when the patient was on a ventilator, and when the patient is very ill and going to pass away, when the vital signs is dropping and so on, even though he is on medication support and ventilator support, when the doctor finds that or decide that the patient is not going to make it, when he orders to reduce the medication, that mean the medication for the heart support, by me doing that, say reducing the medication and all that, do I contribute or some kind of a bad karma or anything? Can you please comment on that?
Thank you.
It is a good question. Many people ask. Now, some people maintain the life by putting tube here, tube here, tube here, tube here. So when you remove these things, that person cannot survive, die instantly. Whether it is by doing that, do they create any bad karma, knowing that he died when they remove these things. Another thing, that recently they practice in Australia, euthanasia. The patient go and request the doctor to take away his life. He requests. They have done. But after that they realize this is very dangerous. Human mind is such, they can misuse. Anything in this world they can misuse. Therefore they have withdrawn this one. Karma we create not by action. Action alone cannot create karma. Cetanaham bhikkhave kammam vadami. Our cetana. Cetana means intention. We must do things intentionally, either kindness, compassion, sympathy, or cruelty, wicked, and what you call dangerous, harmful thing. If these things are working in the mind to do this, then it will become either good or bad karma. You may do lot of thing that which create karma, but they are neither good karma nor bad karma, neutral. Because you did not create that idea in your mind that you want to do that. But action, when you're driving your motor car, how many kills, cats and dogs and some others you may kill, but you never create any bad karma. Because you never think that you want to kill them while driving. Therefore you are completely free. But here, person who is going to die, by force we hold on this by putting all sort of tube. When everybody come to know that this person cannot survive, then they request, why not we remove the thing and to get have the end of it? They do not create any idea in their mind that they want to kill this person. But they know this person's life depart from here when they do that. So that action cannot create bad karma. Death means departure of life. Many people still have not realized what is death actually. This body is not our life. This is the house. Our life live in this house. But in some other world system, life can exist without a shelter, without a body. But in this part of the universe, life cannot exist without a shelter or body. So when the house is getting decaying and decaying and decaying and rotten and rotten and collapse, the life goes away. That is called death. No one can kill a life. Life never dies, please remember. Life never dies. There is nothing to die in the life, it is an energy. No one can see a life. No one can see a mind. But they exist. So, if the rotten house is collapsed, what is the use of staying there? Go away and build another new one. That is called rebirth. Buddha says very clearly this. Vinyanam matukuchismin okkama. That departed consciousness with avidya, trishna, karma, upadana, bhava, with these five mental ingredients in the mind. That is life. Other religionists use another word, soul, because they could not understand the real meaning of consciousness. We can explain what is consciousness, what are the ingredients, what are the energies in the consciousness. But this English word cannot give real meaning of the word used by the Buddha, vijnana. In Pali, Sanskrit language, there are 42 words to explain the nature of the mind. In English language, consciousness, unconscious, semi-conscious. That's all. Therefore, we cannot get the real meaning of the word used by the Buddha, vijnana. That vijnana depart from here, life is there. Therefore, life never die. So why do we worry when it is rotten? Better to kick it out and go and build another new house. By force, we are holding it, keeping for nothing. To suffer more. Many people cannot understand. Whole day and night suffering, suffering physically and mentally. Still they want to live. For what purpose? I really cannot understand. When your passport is expired, my dear friend, you have to renew the passport.